Hey y'all, welcome, welcome, welcome. It is Ebony Evans. I have a very quick and special word for you, and it is all about spiritual agility. So come on in, we gonna get started. I will not be before you for like no more than 10 minutes because I have somewhere to go myself. So praise the Lord, welcome in, welcome in, welcome in, welcome in. I'm gonna give y'all just about 20, 30 seconds. Hey y'all, hey Alexandria, hey BB. Hello everybody, do me a quick favor and share this live with somebody. I should have put the title up, but the name of this video is Spiritual Agility. Spiritual Agility, Spiritual Agility. So I need you to share this live with somebody because this is a prophetic word, but it's something that God is that's getting ready to enhance you. It's not just a word for a season, it's a word for a lifetime. Listen to me. It's not just a word for a season, it is a word for a lifetime. So do me a favor and share this video with somebody you know. It is called Spiritual Agility. Spiritual Agility. And actually, because of time, I'm about to go ahead and get started. Hey, everybody, I love y'all. I'm so excited. Okay, so this is what the Lord has been giving me. Hey, Miss O'Connor. Hey, Sense of Reality. Miss K Love, Jesse. Hello, everybody. I gotta hurry up, so please don't take this as a rush, but I have to give what the Lord has been giving me. Okay, he said the tide is turning. The tide is turning. This is the hour. This is the moment. Greater is coming. Listen to me. This is the hour. This is the moment that greater is coming. New things are arriving. We are in the month of August. August itself, it represents the number 8, and the number 8 represents new beginnings, okay? So the Lord is saying greater is coming. New things are arriving. Waves of glory. Fire of healing. Listen to me. I was in study time yesterday, and this was everything that the Lord was dropping in my spirit as I was praying and warring. He said waves of glory, fire of healing, wind of glory. Hard things are breaking. This is what I heard the sovereign Lord say. Hard things are breaking. Things that you've been dealing with for years, months. It's been cycles of this hard thing that you've been dealing with. God said the tide is turning and hard things are breaking. Barriers are being broken. Listen to me. Barriers are being broken. For the people that just joined in, I need you to share this live with somebody. It is about spiritual agility. God says hard things are breaking. Barriers are being broken. Fresh honey from heaven. Fresh bread from heaven. Like when God gave the Israelites fresh bread from heaven, fresh manna from heaven. God is doing it. New levels, new horizons, new atmospheres, new land, new territory, okay? New atmospheres, new land, new territory. Now I'm about to tie it all in. God says we are on the brinks of overflowing water. Churning is happening right now. I don't even use the word churning. I said, God, what is churning? God said, look it up. Breakthrough gates. So I looked up churning, and churning means to move or shake in agitation, changing rapidly. So those who are warring in the spirit, you are creating a churning in your life. You are creating a movement, a shaking in agitation. Things are changing rapidly because you are increasing in your spiritual awareness. And so God is just literally saying that captivity is loosening its grip right now. Captivity is loosening its grip right now by the blood of Jesus. And Jesus is connecting the dots of triumph, power, victory, and conquering. Okay, so there is a fresh wind of glory that we are getting ready to rest in. Okay, and God says it is going to rest on the people. It's going to rest on your minds, your children, your hearts, your ligaments, your vessels, your organs, your cells. Now, this is what the Lord said. He is granting spiritual agility. God is granting you spiritual agility, okay? So I want you to say or type or both, God is granting me spiritual agility. That should be a declaration and a prayer. You should prophesy over your life that God is granting me spiritual agility. Agility is the power of moving quickly and easily. Nimbleness, okay? And nimble is quick and light movement, moving with ease, agile, active, rapid. So God is granting you spiritual agility. Now, I'm about to make it make sense, okay? Listen to me. So again, agility is the power of moving quickly and easily, okay? The ability to think and draw conclusions quickly, intellectually, and acuity, right? So acuity is sharpness. God is granting you spiritual sharpness, spiritual keenness, spiritual acuteness. You're having acuity of vision, acuity of mind, acuity of hearing. You can hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying, and you're not questioning, is this God or not? You hear God quickly, and God says he's giving you spiritual agility where you are going to be able to move quickly. When God says go, you're going to be able to go without even questioning the Lord. You're going to be able to move without saying like, oh Lord, what am I going to do? You're not going to be worried about the resources because you know that God is granting you spiritual agility. So he's going to grant you the things that you need to go forth. So this is what the Lord is speaking. Now, Nehemiah moved with agility. Listen to me. When God gave Nehemiah the mission to rebuild the wall for the people of Israel, God granted Nehemiah divine acceleration, divine favor, and spiritual agility. Because even when the enemies attacked Nehemiah and they conspired against Nehemiah, even when they came up with all of these plans and schemes to stop him from rebuilding the wall, Nehemiah was so acute. Nehemiah thought on his feet. Nehemiah knew exactly what to say. And I hear the Lord saying that he is literally going to grant the words in your spirit. He's going to give you spiritual responses. You are going to know how to react when it comes to the enemy. That is spiritual agility. That is the power. Listen, the definition itself says the power. Ooh, Jesus, the power of moving quickly. The power and the ability to think and draw conclusions quickly. God gave that to Nehemiah. God gave that to Esther. Esther had spiritual agility. David moved with spiritual agility. You know why? Because they were already connected to God. They already had that intimacy with God. They were already building themselves up in the Word of God, in Scripture of God. So when the enemy came, God gave them instant gratification of what to do. And that is what you call spiritual agility, the ability and the power to move quickly and easy. God has given you a grace to adapt. God has given you a grace to go forth easily without complication. Even when the enemy attacks you, this is spiritual agility. So listen to this. Watch this. This is what the Lord is saying. And I heard this and I was like, Lord, I don't even know about agility. Give me some scriptures that talk about agility. And the Lord gave me Habakkuk 3:17. Now listen to this. It says, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will be joyful in the God of my salvation. Listen, the sovereign Lord is my strength. He makes me as sure-footed as a deer, able to tread upon the heights. In the King James Version, it says he makes me as hinds feet. Hind a hind, I didn't even know this, y'all. A hind is a female deer that can place her back feet where her front feet stepped. Listen to me. A hind is a female deer that can place her back feet where her front feet step. In other words, the hind has what it needs so it will not stumble. So in other words, God is giving you spiritual agility where this is a season that things are getting ready to move fast. You are getting ready to come into the new. You are getting ready to come into greater in what God has planned for you. He already predestined you for this. So a lot of people are getting ready to advance very quickly. It is happening rapidly in your life where you are getting ready to advance. This is something that you've been praying for years, and God has opened the door, and you're going to be able to move with spiritual agility. You're going to have the power and the ability to move with grace, and it is going to happen fast. Some of y'all getting ready to be off jobs. Some of y'all getting ready to come into promotions. Some of y'all, there is a quickening that is happening right now. I told y'all already that we are actually living in a rhema season because you have been putting the word of God on the inside of you. It is literally springing up as a bubbling well. Somebody better hear me now. Somebody better hear me. Listen to me. God is granting you spiritual agility, the power to move and maneuver in a way that is graceful, where things are going to happen so fast, but it is not going to, like, it's not going to struck you. You are already aware of the Spirit. God has already revealed to you that the tide is turning. So the Lord is preparing you. You are already prepared for what He's doing in your life. And so when the Bible says that God makes me as sure-footed as a deer, sure-footed means unlikely to stumble. You have everything you need to go forth. God says it is time to enlarge your faith. Ask for expansion in your faith, because what you really don't understand is you have everything you need. God has been watching you steward over the gift. God has been watching you pray and intercede. God has been watching you fasting. God has been watching you spend more time with Him. So what that did was prepare you for the door that He's getting ready to open. That's why He says, I am granting you spiritual agility to go forth. I am granting you the grace and the quick movement that you need to go forth. Woo, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up in prayer. And I want you to know this. This is so powerful. In Nehemiah, when the enemy kept taunting Nehemiah, Nehemiah said this to them. This was his response. The God of heaven, He will prosper us. Therefore, we His servants will arise. Not people who paint the face of Christian. I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to the servants of the Lord. I'm talking to the people that's living for the gospel and that will die for the gospel. That's who I'm talking to, because those are the servants of the Lord. Notice that it says in the book of Revelation that we overcome Satan by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. And we love not our lives unto the death. Those are the people that are considered the servants of God, because you will do anything for God. Whatever God has laid out for you to do, that is what you will walk in. That is your choice. And so this is what Nehemiah said. The God of heaven, He will prosper us. Therefore, we His servants will arise and build. But you, devil, you demon, you demonic entity, you have no portion nor right, nor memorial in Jerusalem to speak on what God is doing in my life. So this is what God has given you, spiritual agility. He has given you the power and the ability to move quickly with grace in the name of Jesus. And He has given you spiritual acuity, sharpness, acuteness, keenness, acuity of vision. God has granted you aerial view, so you see beyond what's on the surface. So you know that these attacks that are coming your way is because you already know what God has already done and what you're getting ready to walk through. So you're not going to be bewildered by the attacks of the enemy. You already know what the enemy is doing because he's upset about what God is doing in your life. That is what you call spiritual agility. That's why Nehemiah was able to respond with such grace and power when his enemies was frustrated against him and his enemies came against him and conspired against him. It did not stop the work that Nehemiah was doing for the Lord. And God says he is granting you spiritual agility. So let's pray it out. Father God, we thank you right now for spiritual agility. We thank you that you are moving us. We thank you that promotion is getting ready to happen. We thank you that captivity is loosening its grip on the body of Christ in the name of Jesus. We thank you that your children are getting ready to come into the newness of God. You said to forget the former things and to look at what is getting ready to happen. You're getting ready to do new things, greater things, things we have never seen, things we have never known, things that our ancestors have never seen. You're doing it in us. You're giving us blueprints. You're setting us on hills, Father God. You're bringing us forth into the nations in the name of Jesus. God is getting you ready to maneuver throughout the earth, and you're going to spread the gospel. God says greater is coming and new things are arriving. Ways of glory are here and fire of healing has arrived. So Father God, we pray for spiritual agility. And Lord, give us the capacity to study the word of God and to be ready and to be willing and to know what we need to know in these seasons. Give us eagle eye view. Give us aerial view, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Give us spiritual agility. Give us the power to move quickly as you tell us to go, as you tell us what to do. Bless us to move quickly and to move according to the Spirit and to move according to your will, Father. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. We pray for the anointing that you gave Nehemiah. We pray for the anointing that you gave Esther. We pray for the anointing that you gave David, Father. And we pray for spiritual acuity. And we pray for spiritual agility, where we are able to maneuver with ease and grace because we see the vision that you have given us. We see the things. We hear the things in the spirit that you are speaking to us. So no man, no demon, no entity in hell can stop what you have implanted on the inside of us, Father God. So bless us to steward over the word that you have given to us in season. And bless us to prophesy the word. And bless us to pray the word, because it is time to use God's word as a weapon. Woo, Jesus, he's good. So I love y'all. That is all I wanted to say. God is granting you spiritual agility. Please share this live with somebody that will benefit from it. Share it with three people that you know need to hear this in Jesus' name. I love you guys, and I have to go. So I love y'all. Bye-bye.